Hey guys, it's Vignesh from Code Android. In this video, we'll see about conditional statements in Dart. We can check conditions in three ways: if else, switch and case, and ternary operator. If else is suitable to check conditions based on Boolean expression. We can use this separately like this. Also, we can combine multiple if else like this. Switch is suitable for checking multiple cases returned by an expression. This will be helpful to organize our code comparing to multiple if-else. Finally, ternary operator. This will be suitable to take simple decision in single line. If the condition is true, then it will execute true block. Otherwise, it will execute false block. Now, we'll see about these more in the code. I want to check the given number is less than 10 or not. In if else, we can use if number less than 10, then printing number is below 10. In the else case, printing number is 10 or above. You can see it's printing number is 10 or above. In case we want to check whether the number is less than 20 also, then I can add another if else in the else condition. So, it will check the second condition if first one fails. You can see now it is printing number is below 20. In case if you want to print some message only if the number is less than 10, then we can simply remove the else cases. To test this, I am changing the number value to 9. You can see it's printing number is below 10. If I change the number value to 10, then it's not printing anything. Now we'll see how to use switch case. We can't have multiple expression like if, but we can combine multiple cases like this. If any one of these cases gets success, then below code will get executed. So I'm adding more cases from 10 to 19 and then printing number is below 20. All these cases not satisfied, then we want to print different text. To do that, we need to use default case. Note that we need to give break for all the cases except default. You can see it is printing number is below 20. But we can't write the cases for all scenario, so we can do some trick here. For this, we need to pass true as the condition for switch. Inside, for the cases, we can pass the condition like this. Here, we are getting an error because we can't pass variable in case. So, I'm converting the number variable to constant and using that value in the case. You can see now the error is gone. Now, we'll add the condition for less than 20. Finally, adding the default case. You can see now also we are getting the same result. Let's test the number with 20 and it's printing number is 20 or above. This does the same thing, but this will perform better than the above switch case. Switch case will perform better if we have determined value returned by the expression. For example, enums. Ternary operator. Number is less than 10, then I'm printing number is below 10. In the false block, I'm printing number is 10 or above. You can see now it is printing number is 10 or above. Let's add less than 20 check as well. To do that, I need to add another ternary operator in the false block. If the number is less than 10, then this code will be executed. Otherwise, it will execute this code. In this, we are checking whether the number is less than 20. If this condition is true, then this text will be printed. Otherwise, this. Like this, we can combine multiple ternary operator for single line calculations. We will be using this more often in the Flutter to decide whether a widget need to be displayed or not. Finally, we'll see another operator which does only null check. For example, we have a variable and we have some code here which will update the variable. While printing the variable value, we don't want to print null. In this case, we can use double question mark to check whether the variable is null or not. If it is null, then we can pass a default value. Printing channel name, double question mark, then default value. Now you can see our variable is null, so it is printing the default value. If I change the variable and given a proper value, then it is printing the variable's value. Like this, we can do condition check and branching in Dart. In next video, we'll see about loops in Dart. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.